I started to get a chuckle when those individuals that interviewed me on national television, and even at times on in the debates, where I would come up with these ideas about sound money, and there was chuckling and a bit of ridicule, like, what is this idea about believing that the money should be backed by something? You know, the real ridicule ought to be for this silly notion that governments can be trusted to print money when they need it. Now that's silly. But the reason that is so bad politically is that members of Congress and the President do not have to act responsibly. They can do what they think their constituents want. If they want an appropriation, they vote for it. And they'll tax to a degree, but then taxes get too high. And then we borrow, and if we borrow too much, interest rates go up. But then they have this ability to take a treasury bill, send it over to the Federal Reserve System, and they can create $10, $20, $30 billion out of thin air in a single day, like they've been doing recently, to the tune of hundreds of billions of dollars. So this allows governments to grow without being responsible. They end up fighting wars that they should be fighting, promoting the welfare state that they should be promoting, and who pays the bill? You might say, that's fine and dandy, but that can pay the bill and make everybody happy. Only for a while. Because eventually, the people who hold dollars figure it out that there are too many dollars, and then what happens? The value of the dollar goes down, and prices go up. So every time you have to pay for medical care, or high prices in food, or for energy, you have to say to yourself, aha, gasoline used to be $2 a gallon, now it's $4 a gallon, somebody is taxing me. The tax is inflation. The people who produce oil want more dollars because it costs, takes more dollars to buy Europe. So that is a tax. Now who suffers the most? Not the wealthy. The middle class and the poor pay this tax. It's a regressive tax. It's very destructive. And it is a known fact that when you destroy a currency, there is a transfer of wealth from the poor and the middle class to the wealthy. So yeah, you say, well, Wall Street's having a bit of trouble. Not that much. They keep getting bailed out. And when they do have a collapse of a company, you know, the CEOs walk away with tens of millions of dollars in bonuses. You can't do that in real free market capitalism. This is all propped up at the expense of the poor people in the middle class. All we have to do is look toward our neighbors to the south. Central America, South America, how many times have they had destruction of the currency? Mexico's been through it. But the people who suffer is the middle class. They have savings in those currencies and they get wiped out. That is what we're doing to the middle class America today. That's why 90% of the American people today are upset with Washington, and rightfully so. You know, we live in a post-9/11 era, and unfortunately, it has not served us well. During the time of the Depression, we were told that the Depression came about because of capitalism, the gold standard, and we had to be fearful that the government would always take care of us. Well, we're realizing now, after this period of time, the government can't take care of us any better than they took care of the victims of Katrina. They're incapable of doing it. But after 9/11, personal safety became a big issue, and those who love big government, those who do not care about civil liberties, once again use this as an opportunity to promote their cause of central government. You take, for instance, the PATRIOT Act. The PATRIOT Act should never have been passed. But the plan for the PATRIOT Act was laid out a long time before and the loss of habeas corpus, these have all been, you know, in the planning stages. This is why, of course, they did pass another one, this whole idea of having a national ID card. That's why I hope you will get after your representative to make sure that you can resist this national ID, real ID card.
More damaging than